I think we have done with the first and second module yesterday, but anyway, since we have this model question paper, let's just try to look at this question papers as well, and then we can discuss about the other aspects. Okay, so I want everyone to please open your question papers, the model question paper which I've shared. There are two model question papers actually. So I'm talking about the first model question paper, which is model question paper one. Okay, model question paper one. I want everyone to please open that question paper, and then we'll start discussing about it. Everybody has the question papers with you, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. So let's quickly spend some 5-10 minutes on the theory questions, and then we'll start with the fourth module today, as we discussed yesterday. So here, in section A, if you look at all the questions which are asked in section A are theory questions. So no numerical problems are asked here. This may not be the case when it comes to the final exam. Even though the Bangalore Central University model question paper says, this is like all theory questions, but this model question paper is given by one of the, I would say like the one who prepares a scanner or guide or somebody like that. I don't know whether it is released by the university itself or it is by one of these publications. I don't know. I'm not very sure about it. But anyway, since we had the discussion about the model question paper and the syllabus and all that before the commencement of the semester, so there was a clear mention that there'll be at least 60% questions in section A, or which will be problems. That is exactly what was discussed. But we never know, because of Corona and because of online classes and many things like that. In fact, many colleges are of the opinion that giving more numerical problems may not be very convenient, because the students were finding it difficulty because of the mode of classes and all that. So we never know, but whatever this case, as per this university syllabus and the protocol, it is 80% problems and 20% theory. That is what exactly the university subscribed. So we'll just try to follow that. In case if more theory questions are asked to you, I think you should be able to answer them as well, because we have even covered the theory also. Okay, so that is what I wanted to tell you before we discuss about this question paper. Okay, so let me quickly go through the methods. First question rather, enumerate the box check-ins method. This is actually one of the methods which is used in forecasting. So you can find the answer for this question in module one. I think module one, I have given this complete notes about it. This is one of the types of forecasting method. So that is asked for 5 marks. Basically, this method talks about how we can actually have a forecasting done by taking the experts as well as the qualitative data and certain experimental data into account. That is basically how this method has been introduced. And it is considered to be a very conventional method, not very popularly used method these days, but it was quite popular some time back. And once the analytics and many other advancements have happened in forecasting methods, this method particularly has actually taken a backseat. So this is one of the techniques applied by organizations as far as forecasting methods are concerned. And you will find the exact answer for this question in your first module notes. Okay, I want you to please refer that. Second question is about explain the different techniques of facility location. I think we have discussed again this particular concept in module 2 when it talks about the different types of factors affecting the selection of layout and all that. Sorry, module 1 le baratha idu, as far as the plant layout is concerned. So there you can find the answer. Then what is Kanban and explain its types. So this is again the total quality management le baratha. Kanban is basically a system which is used to distribute the work in order. It is almost like a Gantt chart. So Gantt chart tarane baratha, but we are trying to prioritize it on different levels. And the different types of Kanban system, again, we have vertical integration method and other techniques which I've explained there. So this is also in module one itself, total quality management and Bharata. And then question number 4 is about what is vendor rating and discuss its advantages. I think we were discussing about this yesterday, same question. And then what is operation research? What are the characteristics of operation research? So this is actually a part of module 3. So module 3 nal Bharata. Anyway, we have not done that yet. So when I'm taking up that particular chapter, we'll discuss about it. discuss graphical method with example. Again, graphical method comes in module 3, which is used to solve the linear programming problem. So, which is again part of module 3, which I'll take up later. And finally, explain the steps in Ogle's approximation method. So, I hope everybody understands how to solve the Ogle's approximation method by transportation problem. Now, they have asked you a question where you're supposed to explain the steps. That's what exactly I was telling you when I'm solving the problems also. Examinally, operation research questions, instead of asking you a problem to solve, the only possibility is they will ask you to define the steps involved in solving the problem. So if you know how to solve the problem clearly, you can start writing the steps in your own words. There is absolutely no problem. Adre problem complete gothirbek nimge. You need to know the mechanism involved in solving the problem. Then I think there will not be any difficulty in writing the steps. You can definitely write in own words, no problem. So out of 7 questions what they've asked in part A or section A, you're supposed to answer any 5 questions. I think all the questions are direct and simple, and everything is within the syllabus, no application oriented question. So I think there should not be any difficulty in solving the problem. If you have any questions or any doubts with respect to section A, you can ask me. As far as the answers or methods or any doubts, you can ask me, please. Any questions in section A as far as questions are concerned?
No, sir.
Oh, yeah, I think all questions are direct questions. There is no application questions here. I think you should be able to do that. Okay. So coming to section B, basically they're all 10 marks questions, and 5 questions are given to you, and you are supposed to answer any 3 questions. I think all the 5 questions except first question, the 4 questions are, 4 questions only, you are supposed to answer any 3, correct? So out of 4, 3 are numerical problems and only 1 question is theory. I think this is the pattern what they are going to follow even the exam as well. I think this is perfectly fine. As far as the first question is concerned, it's a theory question. It talks about write a short note on the following. Purchase order amendments and concept of lead time. Nenetanenge I was explaining. Usually they'll ask some questions as a short note, and I was specifically taken these questions itself. One is the purchase order amendment. Purchasing functionally, they can take any bit. The most common type of question that can be expected in purchasing is purchase manual, purchase manager functions or characteristics, and how is purchasing done. They may even ask questions about the auctions and rebates. And similarly, here they have asked the question about the purchase order amendments. So purchase order amendments, you are supposed to talk about how the tendering process has revolution over a period of time. Munchella hegaktitondre, the purchasing was normally done at the government level, I'm talking about, basically on the tender system, where you'll be giving an advertisement in the newspaper and inviting the people to send their quote. And it will be usually sent in a sealed quote, which is absolutely confidential. On one particular day, all the people who have applied for tender will be called for a meeting. In front of them, all that sealed cover will be opened, and whichever supplier has actually quoted the lowest amount, in case if he's selling, buying adaga highest amount. On that basis, that particular tender will be awarded. That is exactly how it used to happen for a very long time in India. But now that the IT enabling has started happening in all areas, I think even now in the purchase department, they are following a very important system called e-tendering process, right? There is absolutely nothing to do with the manual interference. Nobody need to send it by courier, no meeting, nothing to do with opening in front of people and all that. So everything is completely done by online. There are softwares available which will automatically pick the people who have selected the or quoted the lowest amount. And they also check the credentials of all the people who have applied for the tender. And accordingly, everything is done with absolutely no intervention by any of the officials. So this is all basically to bring in more transparency in the system and reduce the corruption. That is the whole objective behind that. So you can talk about those factors as well. And the second question is about the concept of lead time. I was talking about the lead time yesterday, and here, if you just look at the lead time as a concept, it's very simple. Very one line answer, very kagado. You can say that it is a time between placing an order and getting the delivery. That is all the lead time is. But if you were to write for a 5-mark question, then you should talk about what are the implications of lead time on the productivity, on profitability, or on the organization as a whole. So you can generally write about it. We know that if the lead time is more, in case if the customer is placing an order today, and if you're taking 1 month to deliver, you know what are the cascading effects. Obviously, the customer will not be happy, he'll be dissatisfied, he will take a decision to cancel the order, or he might go to your competitor and start buying from him. All this could be the various implications from the customer point of view. Similarly, what is the impact of lead time on the company itself? In case if your supplier doesn't provide you the material on time, what is the impact of that on you? Maybe you can start describing from the company point of view, from the customer point of view, and also from the whole industry point of view. So atana nivo a concept na you should be able to elaborate and start explaining. That is how the short notes have to be decided on the basis of how much marks they've asked for. Is that clear to everyone? Yes or no? Is it clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. I think that is the only theory question we have as far as section B is concerned. Now the remaining questions are numerical problems. I want one of you to please tell me, because there is no point in solving the entire problem again. Yeah, problem get doubt is there, athwa it is slightly different, athwa we are not able to understand the question itself. I think that difficult problems we solve. Otherwise, I think we can discuss about the steps involved, so that will be more like recalling what you have done in the previous cases. Okay, so let me take the question number 2 now. The question goes like this: the transportation cost matrix for a given situation for supply of commodity from the sources A, B, C to the points usage P, Q, R is given below. So they've given 3 origin and 3 destination, demand, supply is given to you, and 2 questions are asked here. The first question is, work out the initial basic feasible solution by VAM, that is Ogle's approximation method. And the second question is, does this problem have more than one optimal solution? If so, show all of them. Okay, now let me ask you a question. Now this is a transportation problem. Can anybody please tell me, before we start solving a transportation problem, what is the first thing that we are supposed to verify? I want people to please answer. Yeah.
Balanced or unbalanced, sir?
Very good. So the first thing is you have to check whether it is balanced or unbalanced. I think this question is balanced, I guess. I'm not sure. I have not totaled it. Can anybody please total and tell me how much we get? Is it a balanced or unbalanced problem? 235. Here it is 3.
Unbalanced.
Is it balanced or unbalanced?
Unbalanced.
Unbalanced, sir.
Okay, so unbalanced. I think if it is unbalanced, then obviously first you have to balance it by introducing a dummy row or dummy column, and then you have to solve this problem by Ogle's approximation method. I think the first question is quite clear and simple. I hope everybody is clear about it. Anybody has any doubts with VAM method, Ogle's approximation method? Doubt is there, Gadru? Is everybody comfortable solving that method?
Unbalanced. This 20.
Right? I hope everybody is clear with the VAM method, right? Yes or no?
Sir. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah, somebody has a question. Yeah, please go ahead. Okay. Yeah. So the second question, I think, slightly different. Let me just try to give some insights about it. The second question says that, does this problem have more than one optimal solution? If so, show all of them. Okay, my first question to all of you. How do you determine the optimal solution in transportation problem? Hey, determine madbeko. Hello? How do we determine?
The delta ij should be positive.
No. My question is, how do you determine the optimal solution for a transportation problem? What is the approach? Which method are we going to use for this? ಯಾವ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಇಂದ ನಾವು ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಲ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿಯಬಹುದು? ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಗೈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಮೋಡಿ ಮೆಥಡ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್? ಯಾ, ಸೊ ಮೋಡಿ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಡಿಟರ್ಮಿನ್ ದಿ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಲ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಮೋಡಿ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಡಿ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ದರ್ ಆರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ 2 ಕೇಸಸ್, ಕೇಸ್ 1 ಅಂಡ್ ಕೇಸ್ 2 ಅಂತ 2 ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ 1 ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿಫೈ whether the solution obtained by Ogle's approximation method is optimal or not. Ashte verify maadthivi. And that is done by using the principle of delta ij. If all the delta ij value happens to be positive, that is greater than or equal to zero, then we conclude that the solution is optimal. Okay, that ends the problem. Suppose even if one value of delta ij happens to be negative, then it qualifies to case two, where you are supposed to use the principle of closed path, do all that calculations, and then a new solution is obtained. And please remember, the case two has to be continued till all the delta ij value becomes positive. Agagi, the number of iterations might differ, and it again depends on the value of delta ij. Is to negative value inge bandide adara mele the number of iterations might go up or come down, but by and large, by this particular method we are going to determine the new optimal solution. Okay, illi question is whether the problem has multiple optimal solution anta kelidare. My question to the class is there a possibility of having multiple optimal solution for one problem? Athara sigboda irutta? Hello, my question to the class is there a possibility of having multiple solutions to one single problem?
No, sir.
Somebody said yes. Can anybody please tell me, like, why do you think there is a solution or there is a possibility? Okay, nan nimge explain martin kelkole. ಯಾವಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಲ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಬರಕ್ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಕೇಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕೇಸ್ ಟು. ಯಾವ ಕೇಸ್ ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ? ಇದ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಐಜೆ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್, ಅವಾಗ ಕೇಸ್ ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಎ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಪಾತ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ 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 ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಸೇ ರಿಮೋಟ್ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಮೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಪಾತ್. ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನಮ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತು ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ ಬರೀ ಒಂದೇ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದು. ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ವೇ ದ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ ಕೆನ್ ಬಿ ಡ್ರಾನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಯೂಶಲಿ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ಸಿನಾರಿಯೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್. ಇನ್ ವೆರಿ ರೇರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ರೇರ್ ಕೇಸಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೇ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಗೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಪಾತ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಯುನೋ ಅಲೋಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್. ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ಸ್, ಅವಾಗಷ್ಟೇ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಲ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡ್ರಾ ಎ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಪಾತ್. ನೀವು ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಬರೀ ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪಾತ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಪಾತ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ದೆನ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
There was a power cut. Okay. Yeah, I think now it should be all right. Yeah, I was just discussing about that. Did you understand that concept now, everyone? If at all a problem, if there is a possibility of drawing more than one closed path, vandakinta jaasti closed path draw madlike, if there is a possibility, that is the only way where you can have multiple optimal solutions. Illa andre then multiple optimal solution is not possible. So to answer this question, you should be able to draw the closed path and see if more than one closed path is possible. Did you understand this logic now, whatever I explained? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 99%, I don't think this problem will have multiple choice. I mean, multiple optimal solution, because usually you'll only have one way of drawing the closed path. Ad bandre, then whatever solution you're getting, that is the only answer. So each chapter, and I'm time and again telling you, in transportation problem, three types of questions can be expected. The first type of question is, they might ask you to calculate the initial basic feasible solution using any of the three methods. Which are the three methods in transportation problem? Can you please tell me the three methods in this one? Yeah. Which are the three methods? Sorry? Hello? Can anybody please tell me?
NWCR method.
Yeah?
Least cost method and VAM, sir.
Okay. So NWCR, least cost method, and Vogel's approximation method. Very good. Okay. So idrali yadar one problem varabodu. And the second variety of question that you can expect in transportation problem will be the problem on MODI method. That is 100% sure. Either it can be a question for case study or it can be a 10 marks question. Yadal one guarantee bande baratha. No doubt about it. And the third type of question that can be expected is maximization case problem. Okay. So these are the only three variety of questions that we can expect as far as transportation problems concerned. I think e question paper alle, there is no other question with respect to transportation. So I will take up the next question paper. I'm only trying to concentrate on module 4 today so that we can go step by step instead of taking everything together. So step by step hogana. Now let me go back to your model question paper number 2. I want everyone to please open your model question paper number 2 and let's see, are there any questions with respect to transportation model here? Okay. Section here, we'll quickly go through once. I think again, this question paper also has almost all the questions straight away are direct questions. Let me just go through once. State the advantages of ABC analysis. Okay. I think we have solved numerical problems here, but we have not discussed about the advantage of ABC analysis. Can anybody please tell me what could be the possible advantages of ABC analysis? Yeah, can I get some responses from the class? What are the possible advantages of ABC analysis?
Sir, we Hello? Can
yeah.
Sir, a better inventory management, sir. Depending on the priority.
Very good. Yes. Then any other areas or other applications of it or advantages of it? Okay. Let me just give you a simple clue. See, sometimes it so happens that the questions which we expect it to appear as a problem in the examination, sometimes they may give a theory question related to that. There could be a possibility. Avaganu, please don't panic. If you're able to understand the way we solve the numerical problem perfectly, adrinda namage we'll be able to make out many applications of it. ABC analysis antakshane, the first thought that should come to your mind is, we are trying to classify the entire inventory as three category of items, which are A category, B category, and C category. All right, that is the first point. A category is the items which are the costliest, or the item which is actually the highest or superior in quality, they usually we call it as A items. Okay, and something which is normally abundantly used in the entire process. Second one is B items, which are neither very costly nor which is very cheap as well. Something may be in the middle level. Okay, and C is something which is very inferior, something which is very cheaply available, and something which can be abundantly used also. Adana, on that basis, we normally divide the items as ABC. Now, the classification of ABC is purely done on the basis of the value of the product. A product na value mele, na ABC in the categories marthi. Okay. Now, whenever we talk about the value of the product, it is very clear that, as Rajat was rightly pointing out, you will be able to save a lot of money on unnecessarily stocking the inventory. Okay, because you are parking the money on the items which may not be immediately required, but still if you spend on it, obviously your liquidity position will not be very great. That's one very important advantage of ABC. ABC is also called as always better control. That is the other synonym that is used to define the concept of ABC. What is always better control? This gives a clear indication to the company or to the organization as to understand what percentage of inventory should be maintained in each level. A items eshtu na hold maadbeku, B items eshtu hold maadbeku, C items eshtu hold maadbeku. So the proportion in which the inventories have to be held can be clearly determined, which is an advantage of ABC. And third, the most important application is an inventory policy can be drafted if we have a particular inventory control technique. Now, inventory control technique na yavag apply maadtivi andre athwa hege apply maadbeku andre, it purely depends on the item with which the inventory is actually followed. Please remember, ABC analysis cannot be applied for all type of inventories across the globe. No. Again, we need to understand which is the most suitable area or suitable product for which ABC has to be applied. It is not a universal concept. Adike, we have 9 other techniques available here, which is used according to the market, according to the competitor, according to the demand condition, according to the nature of product. There are so many factors. On that basis, we can take a call as to which is the ideal inventory control technique that can be employed. Adellakkinta important advantage enandre ABC analysis alli. So ABC analysis will clearly give an indication as to what is the flexibility that is available for the company to alter amongst the ratios. Igane matra, let's say A items shortage there. So A item shortage iddaga, I think the company can definitely work on the policies like, are there any possibility of coming out with an alternate items? Okay, alternate items na tagolboda. Suppose if you are going for an alternate item, will it really have hold the same level of quality or not? Will the quality suffer? Such questions can be answered. I think COVID-19 is an all-time best example. I think because of Modi campaign and the agitation that is happening between India and China in the border, I think the government of India and even general public have taken a mass campaign against the ban of Chinese products. The government has banned various apps, almost 15 apps they have banned, and still the process is on, and most of the people are voluntarily banning all the Chinese items and stuff like that. But it is also important for India to understand that there are some specific sectors where we entirely depend on China for our raw material. It is very easy, probably we can say patriotism important to adella sare, adra unless and otherwise we overcome this dependency on China, unless we become self-sustained, this ban may not really have a huge impact on production. Because a few industries cannot survive without getting the raw material from China. I think the best area or the best example is the pharmaceutical. India, most of the pharmaceutical industries, particularly on generic medicine category, we depend on China for the raw material. So we are not self-sustained yet. Overnight, you cannot impose a ban on certain sector or certain industry. Gradually we can do it, and we'll be able to do that very effectively when we are self-reliant, self-sustainable. Aga such campaigns can really make a big difference. The reason why I'm giving this example is, even in ABC analysis also, it will help the organizations to understand, suppose if a particular supplier or buyer is not providing the adequate material which is required, can we think of alternate materials? Can we think of alternate suppliers? Can we think of alternate channels? Such decisions can be made with the ABC analysis also. So these are some of the broader areas where the ABC analysis can have an application or benefits. Is that clear with everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And the second question is, what do you understand by alternate optimal solution? Explain with an example. I think last question paper early, they have asked a numerical problem on that. Now they have asked a theory question. I think I've explained very clearly when alternate optimal solution will appear. You can probably explain that with an example. Ili one hypothetical example ni tagondo explain maadabodu. Okay. So the whole crux of this particular question is, wherever you are able to draw multiple or alternate closed path, that will definitely lead to alternate optimal solution. So you can probably write one diagram where the multiple alternate closed paths are possible, and with that example you can explain that. Third one, discuss the concept of productivity and state the factors affecting productivity. I think it is the first part of module 2. Very in detail, I have given the notes. I think you can go through. It's a very straight and simple question. Not much difficulty over there. And then enumerate EOQ with quantity discount. So, Yeridu concept, we have solved both numerically as well as theoretically. I think it is there in the notes. So, you can probably look into it. So, discounting principles, Mele, we have solved numerical problem. Maybe you can take one numerical problem as an example and you can demonstrate how the decisions are made. So, now, yavaga quantity discount na accept maadidivi and when we are not going to accept it, that particular decision process can be explained here in this particular example. Okay. Define sequencing problem and what are the benefits of sequencing. I think I have given this complete theory in the notes, so you can probably go through that. What is slack and float? We have discussed this in network analysis. So network analysis is slack and float, but we discussed eddy when slack and tail when slack. And float, total float, free float and independent float. Those concepts have to be explained here. Again, we have problems on that. Theory notes only could be there. I've given complete theory notes on that. Maybe you can just go through. And finally, define replacement and what are the replacement policies. Again, the last module that we just finished now. So replacement definition and types of replacement. There are two types of replacement we have. One is called as the individual replacement policy and other one is called as the group replacement policy. So you can just explain that. I think all the 7 questions which are given in section A are a sort of straight and direct questions. So not much difficulty over there. Okay, any doubts or any questions in first 7 questions? If you have, you can ask me. Hello? Any doubts or any questions in the first 7 questions?
No, sir.
Fine. I think then we'll move on to the section B. I think in section B, we have one theory question followed by numerical problems. So the first question is write a short note on. So they have given 2 questions here. One is a VD analysis and other one is FSN analysis. Inventory control technically, definitely there'll be a question. Either they might ask the entire 9 inventory control technique as one single question or they might take pick and choose. So VED analysis. I hope you all remember VED stands for vital, essential and desirable. So this is one of the inventory control technique which I've given in the notes. And second one is FSN. FSN andra fast moving, slow moving and non-moving items. Depending upon the distribution channel and the demand for the product in the market, we normally classify them as fast moving, slow moving and non-moving, which is also one of the inventory control technique. So here the concept now you have to explain. And that will carry 10 marks. A very simple question. Okay. Yeah. I think in the section B, there is only one question, which is on module 4, that is transportation. That is question number 3. Solve the following transportation problem on the Kotidara. I think a very simple question for 10 marks. And the beauty of this question, Andhra, they have not mentioned which method to be used. Andhra, you are free to use any method. Either you can solve this problem by NWCR method, or you can solve by least cost method, or you can do the Ogle's method. I always suggest nimge examinationally, if they have not mentioned any method, you always better solve the problem by NWCR because that is the easiest of all the method and there will be absolutely no question of committing mistakes. Okay, so easy again, 10 marks is the problem will score maadabodu. I think the problem also is a balanced problem, I guess. Yeah, I think it's a balanced transportation problem. So very simple question for 10 marks. That is the only question asked here. Otherwise, the remaining questions are from different module, which I'll take up according to those models. Okay. I think both the model question papers, the questions are quite simple and clear, I guess. There is not much difficulty. So let me quickly go through the question papers now. I am taking the question paper of, I want everyone to please open July 2019 question paper. That is, this is a paper which your seniors wrote. So July 2019 question paper, it is 2.6, quantitative technique and operation research. Anyway, this is not the exact question paper for you, because this syllabus is changed now, but we will only pick up the questions from transportation model so that we can use it for our practice. Okay, that is the idea here. Idralli nimge, you can see the question that is with respect to this transportation here, only one question transportation problem, which is question number 11. I want everyone to please open question number 11. So it's question number 11 in India. They've asked a question on shipping schedule. Okay. So this is a very important point I want to make out. Nimge transportation problem alli, there is one more concept called transshipment problems anta baruthe, athwa shipment problems anta baruthe, which they have removed from the syllabus for you. Nimma new syllabus nalli, we don't have questions on transshipment or shipment problem. Hagagi this particular question is not applicable for you. Because the question number 11 in transportation model is on the basis of transshipment model, which is not part of your syllabus. So therefore, you don't have to worry about it. Adu nam syllabus illa, hagagi I have not covered that in your classes. So in that way, ee question paper alli, we don't have any questions to solve. So let me go to the next question paper. And that next question paper is July 2008. That is just 1 year before that. So our question paper nalli ni open madidre. I hope everybody has opened that paper, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I think they have straight away asked one question on section C. So section C nalli ninge question paper kelidare. Okay, so section C question paper open madidre, you can see that a case study is asked on that. So case study nalli one very important change ide. I want everyone to please go through that case study and tell me what is that difference that you can see in this question. I want everyone to please open question number 2018 July and go to the section C, that is the 12th question, and tell me what is the change that you can see in that particular problem. I want everyone to please go through this question once. Do you able to see any changes in that question? Hello, sir, just 5 minutes, sir. I'm in a class, so just 5 minutes, I'll call you back. Yeah. Yes, 11 o'clock will start. I'll share the link now. Just after this class, I'll share the link because I'm using the same Zoom link now. So once I'm done with this, I'm sharing. No. The classes will start at 11, but I will share the link with you. And you can just open and see. And then 11 o'clock sharp, the students will. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, so can you please tell me what is the difference that you can make out in this question? Hello? Akshita?
Sir?
Huh?
Customers in rupees and the sir, aathara ya question kodala, kottirlila illi tanka anta.
No, don't worry about the customers factory. That is all, origin and destination. Nan helidnana nimge avaru en bekadru name madli, don't worry about labeling. Okay, it is a transportation problem, no doubt, but I'm talking about the
we need to find out the resultant optimal profit.
Yeah, illi nimge kelirodu en important enandre, the question is actually a maximization case problem. Okay, now all the problems what we have solved in MODI method were regular general minimization problem. But maximization problem separate solve madidvi, where we just applied Ogle's approximation method. Final age answer baribekadre, we took the original value and solved it. You all agree? You all remember that? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Ivaga en madbeka ee problem alli andre, first you have to convert this problem to minimization. Okay, regular method minimization convert made and solve by Ogle's method. And do all the problem. Finally, when you are writing the solution, then you should take the original value and replace the values. Andre illi vande vande extra thing enandre, the maximization problem is not ended only at VAM method. We are extending it up to optimal solution. So bere eno difference barala. Final agi when you are writing the answer, you answer baritharalla final agi what is the optimal solution anta by multiplying and all that, avaga we should take the original value. Ad bitre absolutely there is no change. So from this question paper, what you can understand here is you might get a question for optimal solution on maximization case also. That is what it is supposed to be done. Now what I'll suggest is, I want you to please solve this problem. Everybody can please solve this problem. Ee problem na solve made, and tomorrow you please give me an answer. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗಲೇ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾಳೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಏನೋ ನಿಮ್ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ನೋ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಓಕೆ ವಿತ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು? ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಟು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ಅ ಟ್ರೈ. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿ ಲಾಜಿಕ್. ಲಾಜಿಕ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ, ಹೌ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಸೀಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಅಂತ. ಯಾ, ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ, ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟಿ, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವರಿ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇವ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಮೋಡಿ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮೈಸೇಷನ್ ಕೇಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಮಿನ್ನ ಮಿಕ್ಕ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ, ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ನೋಡಿ, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಅ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್, ಅಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಇಯರ್ ನೋಡ್ತೀನಿ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ. ಯಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್. ಅಲ್ಲೇ ನೀವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೋಲ್ ಡೌನ್, ಟೋಟಲಿ ದರ್ ಆರ್ 15 ಪೇಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಜುಲೈ 2017 ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಯಾ, ಜುಲೈ 2017 ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಕೇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್. ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟೇಶನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮೈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಕ್ರೈಟೀರಿಯನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮ್ಯಾಲಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದಿ ಅನ್ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮೈಸೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಅನ್ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮೈಸೇಷನ್, ಸಾರಿ ಮಿನಿಮೈಸೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್. ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನೆವರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಟು ಮಿನಿಮೈಸೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎನಿವೇ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಇಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ. ಅದ್ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ಯುನೋ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟಿ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾ, ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡೇ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 5 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡೇ, ಅಂಡ್ ಟುಮಾರೋ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ. ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ.